Latest controversy to rock Tamil Nadu's education sector. The Vice Chancellor of Anna University, Coimbatore, has been accused of amassing wealth by misusing his position. In fact, the charges against the Vice Chancellor, Radhakrishnan, have been leveled by a Chennai-based lawyer in a complaint submitted to the Governor of Tamil Nadu, who is also the Chancellor of the university. In the complaint, the lawyer has accused Radhakrishnan of granting autonomous status to 7 engineering colleges and also entering into an agreement with a private agency over question paper correction in exchange for money. The complaint further notes that much of the money made illegally, allegedly, by Radhakrishnan has been transferred to an NGO called the Prahar Foundation, allegedly run by his wife, Amrita Sanjeev. Ever since its inception last year, the NGO has reportedly acquired a whopping 60 acres of land worth almost 1.45 crores in and around Coimbatore City. Well, the complaint says that much of the money that was illegally made was transferred to an NGO, the Prahar Foundation, run by Radhakrishnan's wife, Amrita Sanjeev. Times Now is in possession of the documents, specifically the land title deed, which shows that the NGO has got some of these assets ascribed to its name. The petition accuses the NGO has acquired a whopping 60 acres of land worth almost 1.5 crores in around Coimbatore. For instance, like these documents show, the trust acquired property worth 25 lakhs in Nanjundarpuram village in December 2008. This was just after they had acquired land worth 41 lakhs in October 2008 in the same village. The complaint filed by the advocate questions the source of the funding of the trust, as Amrita Sanjeevi does not have a source of income and is a housewife.
Morning, the public interest litigation came up before the Honorable First Bench. In the writ petition, we have moved 2 petitions for taking direction against him from the government of Tamil Nadu, and from also to take another petition for direction has to file an FIR against Mr. Radhakrishnan. After hearing that, we also moved another application by a lunch motion at 2:30 to suspend him for he might use his position for abuse. As well as the inquiry also is going, he must not be in the post. So we will move another 3rd MP number 3, MP number 2 in 2:30, and it's also been admitted. And the Honorable Justice, the First Bench, has ordered to take notice for all the respondents, as the government leader was available in the court.
Well, speaking to Times Now, accused Vice Chancellor of Anna University in Coimbatore flatly denied using his office to influence transactions to benefit the NGO run by his wife.
Have you used the trust name and your position as VC to conduct any irregularities?
No. In fact, for your information, first information I give to you, have denied approval for that trust during the last year, since they got the affiliation from the Council of Architecture very lately.
Okay.
So my administrator is no way connected to any of, not only this trust, we go only by the law.
And breaking news related to this story coming in, the Madras High Court has taken a dim view of the petitioner's views. It has issued notices to the Governor of Tamil Nadu, who is also, of course, as we just told you, the Anna University Chancellor. Governor has asked the Chancellor to reply to the petition against Anna University Vice Chancellor. Petition accuses, as we just told you, the Vice Chancellor of amassing wealth disproportionate to his known sources of income, and accuses the Vice Chancellor of diverting funds to his wife's NGO.